a Labor ex-PM, a Liberal health minister, together to give vaccine confidence a shot in the arm.
They'll listen to you. More than they will to me.
Julia Gillard had the AstraZeneca jab today.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Alongside her one-time rival, Greg Hunt.
Beautiful.
And a lucky sock-wearing Brendan Murphy, the head of the vaccine task force.
Forward-facing, V for vaccine.
Ms Gillard lending her arm to help twist the arm of young women, the group most likely to be vaccine hesitant and susceptible to misinformation.
And make sure that what you're getting is from scientists, not social media influencers.
In 2 weeks' time, GP clinics like this one in Melbourne will begin vaccinating those aged over 70. To start with, there'll be 1,000 practices offering appointments, growing to 4,500. But doubts remain about the government's aim to vaccinate the entire adult population by October.
It's very ambitious and I don't think it's going to be achieved.
The AMA supports the rollout, but some individual GPs are threatening to pull out, angry they've been allocated as few as 50 doses per week and over payment.
It's not fair. It's not fair.
Dr. Maria Bolton, who owns this Brisbane clinic, says she'll either have to work for free or lose money administering the jab. The government pays doctors $30.75 for the first dose, $24.25 for the second, and a bonus $10 if the clinic does both.
So we might be getting someone who's perhaps in their 70s, who perhaps has many, many medical conditions. It's going to take time to get to know that person, and time does cost money.
There are some who wanted to charge the patients an arm and a leg, and sorry for them.
Australia's vaccine tally is now at 81,000, and as our homemade supply comes on tap, the health minister says it'll be 500,000 shots every week. Daniel Sutton for 10 News First.